something a bit different, and I actually met the man who had my job that I have now when I was 14 years old. And I met him, and I said, wow, what a cool job. He gets to work with high school students and help them change the world. Wouldn't that be so cool if I could have that job someday? And here I am.
I think I never had a dream job as a child. Some children dream of being police officers, teachers, nurses. It was probably only when I started college that I started to think about becoming a physician and going to medical school. And at that point, I started to take classes, I started to volunteer at the hospital, and I'm very lucky that I chose a career that I absolutely adore.
My dream job as a child was to become a nun. And growing up in a Catholic grade school in high school, I was taught by nuns, and there was one special, special nun. She was just as cool as she could be. She was lean, and her habit just like flowed on her. She taught us. And she would go out and play grand and jump rope with us, and we just absolutely adored her. And I wanted to be just like her. So I wanted to be a nun, to the point where we played communion.
That's what I was going to be.
You know what? I think I wanted to be a lifeguard at the beach forever. And I realized that I couldn't do that.
So working in the museum has always been high on my list of dream jobs. And after I did the Girl Scout camp in at Kosai as a fourth grader, I think I was pretty much hooked on how fun and interesting it is to wander around museums late at night all by yourself. So I couldn't have asked for a better dream job than the one I currently have.
If I could put a billboard anywhere in the world, I would put one in every community that says, do you know your neighbor? Not just do you know your neighbor's name, do you know what they look like, but do you know your neighbor? I think provocative questions like that on billboards can help us think, who am I? Who are the people who surround me? I think the biggest issues in our community can be addressed by knowing our neighbors if we just took the time to get to know them.
It would say, which has always been my motto, and it's, this is hanging over, this billboard kind of thing is hanging over the trauma room at UCMC, in the operating room, but it says, one mission, one team. And I truly, truly believe in that, from the bottom of my heart. I think that we together have to do it together. We have to be there together or it isn't gonna happen. I don't care if it's an operating room washing the floors in between cases, if it's doing surgery, we have to do it together. I would put the billboard though in our city of Cincinnati. I would put it at the intersection of I-71 and I-75 because I think I love this city. I believe in this city, I love it. And I think together we have to make this happen.
If I could put a billboard anywhere, I would probably put one outside of Union Terminal and have it flash the words thank you to passersby on a daily basis. Thank you to the community for supporting Museum Center for 25 years, for taking care of this great iconic building that we live in and helping us maintain it and use it for the next 100 years.
Over time, my priorities have changed. When I was a young mom and a young physician, I wanted to be a perfectionist. I wanted to be the perfect term room mother. I wanted to be the perfect volunteer. I wanted to be the perfect housekeeper. And most importantly, to be the most perfect physician. Over time, I've learned to let go a little bit, to say, what's really important? What can I let go of? And if I say this really isn't important, I try not to focus on it as much.
I don't think my priorities have changed over time. My priorities have always been my family, and they've always come first. But one thing I remember my father telling me is that business is all well and good and your focus needs to be there, but family is first. But what that means is that sometimes business has to be first because that's what supports the family.
think because of the work that I've done ministering in third world countries, on an Indian reservation here in the United States, here in Cincinnati, in New York, and other cities across the country, I've learned to listen. I think as one gets older, one learns how to listen a little bit more. I've learned to care more, I believe. And the decisions aren't about me. The decisions that I make now are about the people that we serve.
So, I am not a risk taker at all. And my friends would tell you I'm not a risk taker. I oftentimes do things not realizing the challenge of them in the midst of it. So I didn't learn to ski until I was an adult, in my adult years. And we went up the slope after going through the bunny hills a few times. I ended at the top of the lift, got off, and went down a double black diamond without any knowing what that meant. I got to the bottom and my husband was shaking his head at me. Kind of in disbelief, but I didn't know how to stop either. So
I think what people would be surprised to find out is that I'm a diehard Bengals fan, and living in Cincinnati and being a native Cincinnatian, it is sometimes really, really hard to be a Bengals fan. You know, we go to the games, we travel to away games at times, we go to training camp, I read the Bengals blog every day.
So maybe one of the craziest things that I have done is worked in food service, and I worked the late night food trailer in Oxford, Ohio. I was at Chuck Chick's. Chuck was a retired pig farmer who understood serving late night food to college students could be very lucrative. And it's just one of the fun things about understanding human nature. I firmly believe everybody should work in food service or retail at some point in their career to experience customer service, problem solving on the fly, and understanding a lot about humanity.
I don't think I'm known for doing crazy things. I might be a little silly at times. Maybe the craziest thing that I ever did was to go zip lining in Alaska. Or at one point in my younger life, I did own motorcycles.
I've done lots of crazy things, but I wouldn't change any of them.